so I didn't want to have to make this video.
At least we can agree on one thing. You guys all asked for this. This is my response to Noah. The video has, at this point, almost 100,000 views. So yeah, it was time that I made a response. For everybody who is new who found me from his video, hi. I suggest that you stick around to the end of the video because I have a lot to say. And if you still don't like me after watching this video, that's okay. But I do suggest that you watch till the very end because there are already a ton of you sending me messages saying that you're sorry for judging me without actually watching my content and going by hearsay. Let's just get into this.
The reason I actually came around to making this video is because I felt like I had to, because she's someone in our community, as in the LGBT community, and also the YouTube community. I'm struggling to say community, I'm sorry. She's somebody within these two communities that is doing a lot of harmful things, and I don't feel like enough people are telling her that it's wrong. And that's not to say that there aren't people out there that are telling her what she's doing is harmful, but she doesn't listen, and she doesn't care.
I know the people who are watching this who don't like me think that I never listen, and the truth is, I do. But just like in Noah's case, just because I listen to you doesn't mean that I'll change my mind, or doesn't mean that I'll agree with what you have to say.
So I'm sure a lot of you by now are probably really confused. You're like, who the hell is Arielle? No, who is she? So she started off her channel as just a lesbian YouTuber. She made videos about LGBT stuff. She made videos about sex, all that stuff. But now it's pretty safe to say that predominantly her content is about trans people, whether that be on YouTube or Twitter.
These videos were all from the last 3 months. Don't worry, there's plenty more.
I think it's really easy to show a few of my recent videos on screen and tell people that all I do is talk about trans people, when what I actually do is focus on LGBT topics that are current. And I know the current argument is only trans people get to talk about trans stuff. Personally, I think that argument is very weak. I think that specific trans rights affect all genders, especially women. I'm a woman and I will continue to talk about the ways that these different laws and things that are happening in the world affect me. Also, hot take, telling females that they aren't allowed to speak about something that affects them is a form of sexism. You are trying to silence me based on my sex. I believe that I can speak about gender all I want. What I don't think is okay, and which I believe I have never done, is talk as if I have lived, if I've directly lived these trans people's experiences. And if I do talk about that stuff, I have them on the channel. And I don't think I'm speaking over trans people by sharing how gender politics affects me as a woman.
So this whole obsession with trans people, I feel like started off when she made this video about genital preferences. She pretty much says she wouldn't feel comfortable having sex with a trans woman because she's a lesbian and she's not into penis. And it's fine to quickly say your part, like, hey, like, I'm just not comfortable sleeping with someone who is trans. To a lot of people, that's transphobic, and I understand why they see it like that. But there's a difference between simply saying, like, nah, not into it, and repeatedly talking about it so much, all the time, 24/7.
What Noah might not realize is the ridiculous amount of messages I get, the emails, the Facebook messages, the tweets, from young women who feel demonized and ostracized just for being basic, boring lesbians.
And before someone comes and says, like, hey, why can't cis people talk about trans people? That's not what I'm saying. I don't have an issue with cis people advocating for trans rights or, you know, like, promoting and supporting trans people.
So what you're basically saying is that cis people can talk about trans topics, but only when they agree with you? Side note, what about all the trans people that agree with me? And I know you call them transphobic as well, but honestly, why are they the transphobic ones? Why are they transphobic for disagreeing with you? Why aren't you transphobic for disagreeing with them? Who made you the king of trans people and gave you the ability to deem what is and isn't transphobic?
I have an issue with people speaking over trans people.
Again, I don't think I speak over trans people. I think that I disagree with a lot of them, and I will continue to talk about issues that I feel like directly affect me as a woman and a lesbian. And I do promote a lot of trans people's stories. And of course, he didn't mention that in his video, which I don't blame him because it was a hate-fueled video.
And I don't know who needs to hear this, but being a lesbian doesn't give you the right to speak for trans people.
I want you to remember that he said that because it's gonna matter in a little bit.
In the same way that me being gay doesn't give me the right to speak for lesbians. I just wanna say that I have a really big issue with the fact that she brands herself as a women's rights activist and as an LGBT activist, because you can't be a women's rights activist if you don't advocate for all women.
You literally just said that gay people can't talk over lesbians because their experience is different, but as a man, you're telling me how to be a woman's activist. I'm just trying to get this right.
If you don't advocate for trans women, you don't advocate for all women. The same thing goes for being an LGBT activist. If you don't advocate for trans people, you're not an LGBT activist. Like, shut up. That's not like, what? What are you doing?
Serious question, how can I advocate for all women when you just told me to shut the fuck up about trans people? If I can't talk about trans people and trans issues and trans rights and what I think is the best way to go about things, how am I able to properly be an LGBT advocate, as you say? I personally feel that I critique and praise all women equally, regardless of, you know, if they're cis, trans, or whatever. When lesbians say some dumb shit, I call them out. When trans women do some dumb shit or say some dumb shit, I call them out. I let them know. That's all I'm saying.
So my first point to make on her transphobia is her opinions on pre-transition trans people. And if you've managed to get this far through the video without knowing what the definition of transgender is, here you go. So here's a fun video that she made reacting to my friend Jamie, who is trans. What a surprise, that's so unexpected.
I am a guy, and my partner is a cis woman, meaning we are a straight couple.
You're a straight couple in the eyes of society because you look male, even though, again, your chromosomes are probably XX. Like, I don't know what your chromosomes are, Jamie, and I'm not trying to be triggering to you, but if people saw you on the street, they would assume that you are a male. You're presenting as a man, you pass for cis, is really what I'm trying to say. So yeah, in the eyes of society, you pass as a man, your girlfriend passes as a woman, you would be seen as a straight couple.
According to the LGB Alliance's belief, we would be categorized as lesbians.
If you're a trans guy that has not gone on testosterone and that has not had any permanent body changes and you're still calling yourself a straight couple, I question that.
So pretty much what she's saying in this video is, hey guys, your sexuality and your gender are determined by how other people perceive you.
Well, yeah, part of experiencing your gender and your sexual orientation does have a lot to do with how other people see you. Think of it this way, being a woman or a man means a few things, in my opinion. It's not just simply an identity. You can have or want a female body. That would be physically being a woman, right? Otherwise, gender dysphoria wouldn't be a thing. Females compared to males have different hormone levels, different biology, and that means that mentally and emotionally, there also will be differences. And a big part of being a woman is seen by others in that way. Like, you are treated differently by most, if not all, of the world for simply being female or being perceived as such. If you identify as a woman, but pass as a man, in my opinion, you don't know what it's like to live in the world as a woman. What you do know is you'd know what it's like to live as a man who identifies as a woman. Females who are seen as women can't magically identify out of their sex-based oppression, so please don't invalidate actual female experiences for what may or may not be going on internally in someone's head.
Which is obviously not true at all. Like, that's not how it works. So many issues. Just want to put this out there if you haven't realized by now, but like, saying trans men aren't men and saying trans women aren't women because they haven't transitioned yet is transphobic.
In my opinion, saying trans men aren't men and trans women aren't women if they haven't transitioned isn't transphobic. It's recognizing reality and your place in the world and how the world views you and how the world will treat you. Almost every single trans person that I personally know, when talking about their past, will say things like, when I was a girl, when I was a boy. I believe that that's their way of acknowledging their life before they transition. They are acknowledging that this is the way they were perceived, even though that's not the way they felt.
Which is obviously not true at all. Like, that's not how it works. So many issues. Just want to put this out there if you haven't realized by now, but like, saying trans men aren't men and saying trans women aren't women because they haven't transitioned yet is transphobic.
Again, let's go back to the different ways of experiencing womanhood or manhood. Physically, mentally, emotionally, socially, or societally. Pre-everything, the only aspect of that that a trans person would experience is the mental part. My question is, what about the other three parts? And I know Noah doesn't want to hear this, but how society views you does matter. Otherwise, you wouldn't get triggered if somebody misgendered you.
I haven't had bottom surgery. Does that make me a woman? In your eyes? Is that it? And also a thing that people seem to ignore is that some people can't medically transition. Whether it be for financial issues or medical issues or social issues in your inner circle, it's a thing that people go through where they can't transition medically even though they want to. Healthcare is expensive in a lot of places, and also, in a lot of places, the waiting list for medical intervention for trans people is ridiculously long.
I've never said that people that don't transition aren't trans. What I did say is I believe it's a very entitled way of thinking or being to expect people to treat you as the gender that you identify as if you still present fully as the sex you were born as. If you still present as a man and you expect people to know that you're a woman or vice versa, that's very entitled. With all that being said, I personally do my best to treat someone how they identify as, no matter how the rest of of the world sees them, within reason though.
Some people have medical issues that prevent them from being able to go on testosterone or estrogen. I know a few people that haven't been able to get surgery because their mental health isn't good enough, or because their physical health isn't good enough. That doesn't make them not trans, it just means that physically they can't go through it. And honestly, this video just makes me question her views on the trans people she knows, and the trans people she calls her friends. Like, does she think they're not trans unless they've had surgery?
No, I think someone isn't trans if they don't have any type of gender dysphoria.
Here's a tweet that I found, and yes, it's an older tweet, but that video I just showed you was a few months ago, so her opinions have not changed. She tells someone, maybe it's time for you to change the way you see lesbianism. This person replies, the way I see lesbianism is girls who are into girls and not other genders.
The person that I'm responding to in this tweet exchange is actually bisexual or pansexual or something. So, Noah, didn't you say that someone of one sexual orientation shouldn't be speaking for another? That was from before in the video. I'm just making sure you guys remember that.
Being trans is similar to sexuality in that it's something that you know of yourself. You don't have to do anything in order to be that sexuality or to be transgender. It's just something that is a part of you. Also, I'm not gonna get into it because that could be an entire separate video, which I'm not gonna make, by the way, but she is obsessed with other people's genitals.
So Noah, earlier in the video, you said that it's okay to lift trans voices as long as I'm not speaking over them. That's exactly what I did in these videos that you're referring to. Yes, I talked to trans people about their genitals. I talked to trans people about different experiences, different surgeries, different sexual orientations, how their sexual orientations might have changed after they went on hormones. And all of the people in those videos were comfortable about themselves, or at least talking about themselves, to educate people.
Let's go on to her views on non-binary people. So going back to the idea that she speaks over people, she's got this thing with non-binary people where she doesn't understand what being non-binary is, so she tries to tell non-binary people what being non-binary should be. Here's a little thought, Ariel. Non-binary people know what non-binary is, and they don't need a transphobic lesbian to tell them what they are.
Here's a quick tip. If you are advocating for a certain type of person's rights, or societal acceptance, or what have you, it's important to define what that is, what makes that person different, what oppression they are facing. If you're claiming to be oppressed by being non-binary, you do need to define it for other people. Like, there needs to be a set definition, in my opinion.
TERFs are radical feminists who don't include trans women in their conversations about women, unless it's to shit on them.
I choose to include trans women in my conversations about women when it's fitting. Trans women don't have periods. I'm not gonna have a trans woman in a video where I have a menstrual cup sponsor. Like, that doesn't make sense. Trans women don't have periods. Trans women don't know what it's like to have an abortion or worry about being pregnant. And in my opinion, they shouldn't be directly included in the conversation when it does not directly affect them. Can they have opinions on it? Of course, but I'm not gonna feature somebody's voice when it has nothing to do with the topic at hand.
Is TERF a slur? And 61% of her followers said it was. And you could say that, you know, she was just asking a question. Maybe she was just interested on, you know, what people thought.
Well, no, I mean, TERF originally wasn't a slur, but part of a slur depends on the context of the word and how it's being used, right? In my experience, the majority of the time the word TERF is used is to demonize anybody who disagrees with the subset of the trans community or the queer activism community. And I'm not a TERF for disagreeing or questioning or critiquing ideas that I think are bad.
But it's a question that shouldn't have to be asked.
There's a website called TERF is a Slur. I suggest you guys check it out. I'll have it linked in the description below. It shows how ridiculous people can be just for simply disagreeing with a woman that has an opinion. You can very quickly tell how as soon as somebody is deemed a TERF, everybody else deems it acceptable to spew hate, to threaten, to harass, to stalk, just because they're deemed a TERF. That's why I'm calling it a slur.
What I was saying was that in a discussion about the difference between trans people committing crimes, which, by the way, it's a bit scary how she has so many links readily available for examples of trans people committing crimes. It's a bit weird to hate trans people that much.
Yeah, I have tons of links saved on my Twitter because so many people are talking about it at the moment and I want to either just read what they had to say.
In a discussion about there being a difference between trans people committing crimes and cis people committing crimes and then claiming to be trans, because they're cis guys who want either an easier time in prison because they're surrounded by women, or because, you know, they're sexual predators and they, you know.
Multiple people have been talking about this. Blair White is one of them. I believe Rose of Dawn also talked about this. There are multiple people out there who are claiming they are male, they are claiming to be trans women to, in my opinion, get a better prison sentence or to get off easy, etc. So this is not trans hatred. This is something that's actually happening. And I think that trans people who aren't calling it out are actually making it worse.
She used a link from a TERF website as a source.
I also didn't know that that was a TERF website. But regardless, just because you don't like the person or the website who said thing doesn't mean that said thing is incorrect.
And if you look at her channel, it's clear to see that she is a transphobe. But understandably, it's a common thing with trans people where we feel like we're not enough. And that to be enough, we have to appeal to the community of cis people that, you know, also view us as not enough. And it's for this reason that trans people will put up with the bare minimum of acceptance. I don't agree with you, but I support you, comes to mind when I think of Ariel. There also seems to be this vibe of like, I'm not like other trans people with the trans people that, you know, associate with her. Like, cool, transphobes aren't gonna hate you any less because you're also transphobic. Honestly, the thought of trans people promoting her, it disgusts me and it makes me feel embarrassed. But, you know, maybe I should give them the benefit of the doubt. Maybe somehow they didn't know that she was like this. I think it's pretty clear to see that she uses trans people for views, and also to further the idea that what she's saying is acceptable, because, you know, like, I can be transphobic, but this trans person is here, also agreeing with the things I'm saying. I can't. I have a trans friend. That's not transphobic. Here's something that she tweeted recently. Plenty of people agree with me. Do I need to start with people who can have say in this as well? And she adds for trans people. And this further proves that she is using trans people to make it seem like her behavior is acceptable.
No, it proves that not all trans people think like you. You do not speak for all trans people. I do not speak for all lesbians.
This, I have trans friends, so I can't be transphobic, is exactly the same as I have black friends, so I can't be racist. And also she tagged Buck Angel. If you're trying to show that you have trans friends who have reasonable views, he is not the person to use.
Do not come for Buck Angel. He's amazing. Just saying. He has been advocating for transgender and transsexual rights for longer than you've been alive.
It just seems like a recurring theme that the trans people she is friends with are insecure in themselves.
I think it's a very common argument to state that people who agree with me hate themselves. But to be completely honest, I find the exact opposite to actually be true. I hope you enjoyed this video and hope you watch till the very end to hear what I had to say about all of this. If you are new and want to see what I have to say about all other topics, click subscribe. And other than that, I will see you guys back here in a few days with a brand new video. Until then, love you, love yourselves.